Whew. The Transmart Apollo Bolt is a terrific bass-heavy earbuds that's jam-packed with technology inside. If this thing doesn't impress you, I don't know what will. Anyway, the sound is really good. It's bass-heavy, yes, but it doesn't compromise on the mids and highs. Everything about it screams high-tech, from the flagship QCC chip to the features packed in. We have a lot to talk about, so let's just roll the intro right now. Selamat pagi! Good morning everyone, Kenneth here, and today we'll be talking about, finally, the Transmart Apollo Bolt, which got me worried at first unboxing that it will be too bass heavy. But after using it, oh boy, I think I love bass more than ever before now. But before we talk about it, disclaimers first. This unit is sent by Transmart free of charge, but rest assured, because everything said here is my own honest and unaltered opinion. I'm not paid by anyone, so if you want to help me support the channel, please consider using the links in the description below to get to Shopee, Lazada, AliExpress, Amazon, and you can use it to buy anything, really. You just have to go through that link. But as always, hit a thumbs up if you're excited and subscribe if you haven't, because we're going straight to the most important one, the super mega inspiring bass sound. Alright, let's get serious here. This earbuds has insane bass. And for a brand like Transmart, who's been focusing on the vocals and trebles for as far as I remember, this came as a surprise. And if you compare it to the cheaper bass-focused earbuds like the Realme Buds Q, Tissot i6, well don't! This thing blows everything out of the water. I never thought songs like The Weeknd by SZA could have bass that you can really, really feel. It's not just the book, book, book sound, it vibrates so deep into your skull. It really feels like Transmart stuck a subwoofer inside this thing. It's crazy, this doesn't even push your chest like you're inside a club or something. But the problem is, with earbuds like this, usually the bass bleeds out and muddies the highs and mids. But that's not the case here. The other frequencies just take a backseat, because obviously the lower end is the focus here, but it's still very, very detailed, very well separated, and in quiet parts where it's just you and the vocals, it's very natural sounding. I just love it. It's not annoyingly bass heavy, it's satisfyingly bass heavy. Oh, I've listened to every Yoroshika song in this earbuds and I bang my head hard. Every slap bass, every drum kicks are so much more fun compared to even my favorite earbud at the moment, the Galaxy Buds Plus. It felt, where's the bass? And in all their rock songs, like the four songs at the top of my review playlist, I'd say they don't sound the best here because I'd prefer the vocals to be more in focus, but it's nothing that I can hate. That makes it the first time I enjoy listening to rock songs in a bass-heavy sound signature. Usually I can't stand it even for like a minute or something. But not only that, you can imagine how good it is when listening to hip-hop, rap, EDM, or even pop music. It's just killing it. I even tried listening to Time to Say Goodbye or You Raise Me Up. They all sound fantastic. So aside from being bass heavy, there really is nothing wrong with the sound in my opinion. It's the best bass focused sound I've heard to date. Now let's move on to the build, quality, and the fit. With all the great tech inside the earbuds, I can see how Transmart tries to cut cost in the case here. It's just a plain plastic case with 500 mAh battery inside. That's probably good for another charge or two because the earbuds battery are so big inside, we'll talk about it later. And no wireless charging, but fortunately it uses USB-C. And there's one LED in front that blinks white when it still has battery above 10% and blinks red when it's below 10%. You can see here, it's red right now. Fortunately, they paid attention to the lid here, which is spring-loaded, so it always tries to stay open until you really want to close it. And by the way, Transmart gives you a pouch to carry this around, so don't forget to take it out of the case and use it. Now let's talk about the earbuds. And first of all, the size is huge, and it sticks out quite a bit too. So it will look a bit off if you have smaller ears, and you can't really use this when sleeping sideways. And that's because it packs in a crazy 85 mAh battery inside. This thing can play 10 hours of music at 50% volume, ANC off, which is actually just the right loudness if I'm going to listen for it that long, or even I can put it on 30 and 40 and just be fine with it. And with ANC on, it drops to around 7 hours, which is still good. And in all honesty, I would never listen to that long, probably 4 hours max. But if I'm in a long flight, that extra battery would really come in handy. Although when it's completely depleted, charging will take something closer to 2 hours, which is quite long. It is IP45 water resistant, so you still want to keep it away from water, but for everyday sweats and exercises, it's perfectly fine. I've never had a problem with the fit, although it's important to note that the ear tips is quite big. So if you have a smaller ear, again, this might not fit you. But having said that, I have a pretty big ear here and I don't feel any pain even when using this for hours and hours on end just to cancel out noise while writing a script or something with ANC on. The overall build quality is just very solid, and that can also be said to what is inside. You might have seen the wording QCC5124 chip, right? Basically, this is the expensive stuff from Qualcomm, but it's still the cheaper ones in the lineup, so there are a few missing features when compared to the other even more expensive options. But first, let's talk about what this chip enables. First, it is very efficient. Just like the cheaper QCC3020 we see everywhere, this chip lets us have that 10 hours of music playtime. And also, it has the multi-microphone CVC technology that makes call quality pretty good. We're gonna see this tested later. Second, it enables ANC, and not just your average cheapo ANC. It's a hybrid one that uses two microphones to listen to noises from the outside and the inside. So the result is a clean noise reduction without much added pressure or any background hiss. And not only that, this also supports ambient sound mode. And this is really good too. It doesn't sound tinny at all, the amount let in is just right, and the mic being used is on the top here. So unlike the Galaxy Buds Plus, you don't cover it like too much whenever you are handling the earbuds, so there's no such like screeching sound. If you have the Galaxy Buds Plus, I think you'll know it. Overall, the quality is just one of the best I've tried so far. Now the third one is this chip doesn't interrupt your music when you toggle between different modes of ANC. I know this is like such a small thing that may not matter to you, but I don't know, if you appreciate it like I do, then the next level would be to talk to Siri without interruption, which this still does and the AirPods doesn't. So yeah, I'm that guy who will hate you if you change the song in the middle of it playing. Put it on cue, please. Now let's talk about what isn't on this chip. First, it only supports standard aptX, so no aptX adaptive for the ultra low latency performance. I kind of had my hopes up for that, and no aptX HD as well. Second, it's still true wireless stereo, not true wireless mirroring. So basically, if you don't utilize aptX TWS, which is only supported on Snapdragon 845 and above, you will have to wait for a few seconds when you switch between right only or left only. And third, it doesn't have voice activated assistant, but it's no big deal. I just wanted to let you know because this is a new feature that we're going to see in their new flagship QCC5104X series chip. I know you might be confused with all these weird names I'm spitting out, but there are a lot of cool techs from Qualcomm. And if you're interested, you can check this video out. I've explained everything about QCC chips as well as how aptX TWS and how it is a big deal. Now, all the tech talk aside, how does the experience really is? We've talked about the ANC and ambient mode already, so what's left is the controls and the app. It's only recently that Transmart released their app. It's got some EQ presets inside, but I don't find any of it to be any good, so let's just not talk about it. But along with it, they pushed a firmware update that lets you know which earbuds is the master side. It's an okay feature, but this one is more important. It lets you customize the controls. It's not like the controls are bad in the first place. In fact, it was perfect the way it is. In addition to single, double, and triple tap and hold, now we also have tap once and hold gesture to activate Siri. And on top of that, these earbuds also has a wear detection sensor, which works flawlessly in auto playing or pausing any of your media, music or video. Anything will do. And seriously, I have no problem with the control scheme other than it's just pretty slow to take effect, so it doesn't feel as responsive or quick whenever you want to try to do something. But with this update, let's say you accidentally single tap a lot or for whatever reason you don't want any of these controls, now you can just turn it off every spot on every side can be set to anything that you like. And it's just very cool to see Transmart doing this. I just wish they add something like sensitivity setting in the future. Anyway, I've talked enough. Let's check out the latency and a call test right now.
See how fast it connects, and okay, there you go. So we are now connected. And what do you think of the sound quality? In my opinion, it should sound one of the best because it has so many mics inside. I think it has 3 microphones. There are just holes everywhere in the earbuds itself. Now we're gonna identify which mic is being used. I think it should be on the right side, you know. Yeah, this is how it sounds indoors. Let's go ahead outside and we'll see how it sounds. So right now we are on a Transmart Apollo Bowl, and yeah, I think it's a pretty nice experience because I can hear the sounds around me, so I can be aware when, you know, I'm having a call. So yeah, it's good to have that ambient sound mode, so noise cancellation on. And we can see, oh my goodness, I can really hear that the low rumbles are totally gone. That is pretty cool. I feel like I'm in a very empty beach, just lying down like that with some wind blowing to my face. By the way, there's some wind blowing. Well, can you hear that? Or can you hear just my voice? Okay, wind's getting strong. I can blow away. So yeah, what do you think of the sound quality? I think this should be good. Playing around with the active noise cancellation during the phone call is pretty nice. Okay, let's go back upstairs and we'll finish the video.
So, in conclusion, for $100, you'd be hard-pressed to find something better than what Apollo Bowl has to offer here. It's got amazing bass-focused sound, a premium chip that gives you good call quality, amazing ANC and battery life, and then pair that with the perfect controls that's customizable now, and good enough charging case. We have got a winner here. So what do you think of the Transmart Apollo Bowl? Are you planning to get it? Let me know down in the comments below. And if you're looking for ANC earbuds, this is just a start. I will cover more in the coming weeks, so don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Kenneth, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.